Let's take a look at how to create an online assignment on Gradescope. Online assignments allow instructors to create a variety of questions on Gradescope that students can answer directly within the interface by typing, selecting, or uploading their responses. To start, from the course dashboard, let's select Assignments on the left and click to create a new assignment. We will select the online assignment type. For online assignments, first, we need to set a release date when students can start the assignment and a due date when their work must be completed. If we'd like, we can also set a time limit, giving students a set number of minutes to complete the assignment from the moment they click start and see the questions. Let's set the release and due date for this online assignment so that it's available to students for 24 hours and set a time limit that gives students 60 minutes to complete the assignment within that 24-hour window. Once we've set our dates and time limit, let's click Create Assignment. So we're now on the assignment's Create Outline page. From here, we can create our questions. There are five types of input fields that we can use with online assignments on Gradescope. Student answers to questions with multiple choice, select all, and short answer input fields will be auto-graded by Gradescope as correct or incorrect. Whereas student responses to free response and file upload questions need to be manually graded by the instructor. Let's create a five-question quiz that has one question for each type of input field. We'll create three auto-graded questions first. Our first question is a two-point multiple choice question, so we'll put the point value and question title at the top and select the multiple choice field. We can now fill in the question text and answer options, with the correct option being marked by the X. Our second question is a four-point select all question, which is just a multiple choice question with multiple correct answers. We'll mark each correct answer with an X, and students will need to select all correct answers in order to get auto-graded as correct. Our third question is a five-point short answer question. Short answer questions are questions that have a single correct answer, which could be a number or a word. We'll put the correct answer in the parentheses. Note that we can use LaTeX and Markdown when editing our questions, and we can preview the formatting on the right side of the screen. Finally, let's create two questions that will be manually graded. Our fourth question is a 10-point free response question. Students will see a text box where they can type the response. If we want, we can add an image to the question body, and that image will be rendered to students. Our final question is a file upload question. If we insert a file upload field, students will be able to upload a file of any type to this assignment, such as images of handwritten work, PDFs, code, or anything else. Note that we can also insert multiple input fields per question, so if we wanted to, we could add a free response field here as well. Once we're done, we can save the assignment. If we want, from the Extensions tab here, we can set time limit extensions for specific students, such as students with accommodations. For more on the student workflow for submitting online assignments, check out our online assignment submission video for students. As students complete the assignment, we'll see each student's start time and the time of their most recent submission on the Manage Submissions page. If we ever want to create a submission on behalf of a student, we can do that via this new submission button, and we can click on the student's name to view their most recent submission. Once all submissions are in, we can grade them from the Grade Submissions page. Multiple choice, select all, and short answer questions will be graded automatically, but we can adjust the rubric if we'd like. For example, if we wanted to award partial credit. For free response and file upload questions, we'll grade them manually by building custom rubrics, as shown in the Grading a Simple Question video.